Hello and welcome. I'm Amritanshu Rai and you're watching Law of the Land on Raj Sabha TV. Today we bring to you the Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Amendment Bill 2015. To discuss the issue, I have with me Mr. Rajiv Chawla, Chairman, Integrated Association of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, and Mr. Mukesh Mohan Gupta, Director, Dena Bank. Now for the headlines. The MSME Amendment Bill seeks to enhance the investment limits prescribed currently. The amendment redefines micro, small and medium enterprises so that more entities can take benefits of government schemes. The central government empowers itself to change investment limits up to 3 times the specified limits through notifications. The Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Amendment Bill seeks to enhance the investment limits in the plant and machineries of the MSMEs. The proposed amendment redefines the micro, small and medium enterprises so that more enterprises can be brought into the ambit.
Once the bill is approved by the parliament, MSMEs are likely to get benefit. The existing investment limits were fixed in the year 2006, after which there has been a notable increase in price index and cost of inputs. Therefore, the MSMEs were not able to get the benefits which it should have been getting as they had gone out of the defined parameters within the law. The amendments now revises the parameters, keeping in mind the current business environment.
The SMEs definition in India is different than the SMEs definition globally. Now, they have different parameters for the definition. But somewhere, we need to be coming to the levels of the global standards of the definition of SMEs. So when this Make in India campaign is being run across the world, where we are inviting companies to set up factories in India, I think we need to be matching the standards globally for the definition of SMEs. And this is could be one of the major steps for this initiative of Make in India.
The limit of investment in plant and machinery for enterprises engaged in the manufacture or production of goods and the limit of investment in equipment for enterprises engaged in services has been increased. In the year 2006, investment limits for enterprises in manufacture or production was 25 lakh in micro enterprises, 25 lakh to 5 crore in small enterprises, and 5 crore to 10 crore in medium enterprises. Whereas in MSME Amendment Bill 2015, the proposed investment limits are 50 lakh for micro enterprises, 50 lakh to 10 crore for small enterprises, and 10 crore to 30 crore for medium enterprises. The investment limits for enterprises providing services in MSME Act 2006 was 10 lakh for micro enterprises, 10 lakh to 2 crore for small enterprises, and 2 crore to 5 crore for medium enterprises. Whereas in MSME Amendment Bill 2015, the proposed investment limits are 20 lakh for micro enterprises, 20 lakh to 5 crore for small enterprises, and 5 crore to 15 crore for medium enterprises.
In the SME sector, which are looking forward to entering other areas of manufacturing. Now they'll have the leverage of putting in more money and putting in more sophistication, but bringing in more technology, which is earlier not feasible. And once technology comes, once the area of manufacturing expands, it's likely to increase employment generation, as has been happening in these industrial areas. And more specifically, when you're talking of Make in India.
The Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Bill 2015 was introduced by the Minister for Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, Kalraj Misra. The bill amends the Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Act 2006.
MSMEs not only play a crucial role in providing large employment opportunities, but also help in industrialization of rural and backward areas. MSMEs are also considered complementary to the large industries. With cameraman Saroj, Dipali Pandit for Rajya Sabha Television.
The government sees the MSMEs having the potential to generate highest employment opportunities. Mr. Chawla, the straightaway question. You've seen the enhancement of the definitions on various levels, services, manufacturing and things like that. Where do you see the, how do you see it impacting the existing current legal framework, which is how many more will be able to come, or does it need further redefinition?
I think the best thing about the bill is that it also seeks to empower the government to raise these limits up to 3 times through notifications only in due course of time. And they would be linked to the cost inflation index. Mm-hmm. I think this is just apt because the present limits, as the documentary also mentioned, were laid down in 2006. Looking at the cost of investments, the cost of the capital goods, the capex one enterprise or an entrepreneur needs to make, these limits needed to be raised. The limits recommended in the bill today, I would say, are bare minimal. Mm-hmm. In fact, if you see, these are just about doubling the limits. While if I look at the cost inflation since 2006 through 2015, as we are today, the limits should have been much higher, even as of now. Mm-hmm. But I'm still happy because the limit would empower the government to increase through notifications later on. Every time, we don't have to go to the parliament and, ensure
we'll make the government more dynamic.
That's right.
Any inputs on that?
See, these limits have been discussed on various platforms. What happened, the government has formed a KV Kamath committee also. Mm-hmm. So it is not that hypothetically they have fixed up some limit, in fact. So we have at the ministry level, there is a national board for MSME. I am proud to say that I have been nominated in that board also. So we had a lot of discussion on this. Kamath committee has also recommended the same limits, in fact, which have been recommended by the ministry and are supposed to pass like an act, in fact. So I suppose some start has been made. There. Hmm. Yeah. So it's a good thing because I'll tell you one more thing. There was some opposition also for the increase of the limits by some of the associations.
Okay.
What they were saying, they were of the opinion that, then large units will come under this ambit, in fact. Mm. So one part of that association was there, in fact, they were. But then it was a conscious decision, in fact, that we should increase the limits of, capital.
To bring more entities
more
into
thing,
the ambit.
To bring more entities, and moreover, there is a growth. Mm. So ultimate aim of the government and the society is to
keep growing.
As micro should be converted to small, small to medium. Mm-hmm. So, and then when any unit goes to a medium sector, in fact, earlier limit, mm-hmm. That unit was out of that, in fact, MSME benefits.
Right.
So that was also one demand, in fact, that when they grow, they will be out of the benefit of the MSME sector.
Okay.
So that was also considered, in fact, and I suppose this is, like Rajivji told, it's a good initiative, uh-huh. that at least some start has been made. And the government and that this dynamism is rightly told is there, in fact.
On the issue of delayed payments, has that been addressed?
See, that has been, that's a very big problem, in fact. That's the biggest problem of MSME as of today. Even I'll say to that extent that even the finance, which is the most talked about subject of the MSME, that is also not as important as the delayed payment. Because on the finance, they have to pay interest. Mm-hmm. But here in the delayed payment, their own money is stuck up in the PSUs or the large corporate. So what is happening, in fact, there has been 2-3 initiative by the government, in fact. Royalji, I'll say that abhi nahi to kabhi nahi. Mm-hmm. That ministry is very proactive, in fact. For this delayed payment, this has been made mandatory, in fact, from the 1st April 2015. But I would like to add one more thing, that implementation will not be very easy. Another aspect has been added, in fact, that e-discounting of the receivables has already been started, mm-hmm. with the help of NSC, mm-hmm. by SIDB. That will also add something, in fact. So it's our duty to
mean to say there is no interest being paid by PSUs for delayed payments beyond a certain point on the payments that are receivable by the MSME? Is that so or not?
Yeah, is that so? But now
And what's the delay like in terms of gaps? 6 months, 8 months, 12 months, 1 year, 5 years. What is the gap like?
So they're all
working, on an average.
All their working capital is all stuck up there, in fact. So the normal payment terms, you say 2 months, 3 months. Mm-hmm. But they are not paying it like that. Now the amendment is there. One more thing I'll just like to...
I'll bring in Mr. Chawla. Yes, Mr. Do you think that's a problem?
Actually, the present payment delayed issue, as is being tackled by the bill, it empowers the state governments to set up micro and small facilitation councils. Now, actually, it becomes a state issue in that case, because all these cases, when micro and small enterprises they raise, they go to micro and small facilitation councils of their respective states. Now, it is the effectiveness of those state MSME facilitation councils that matters. For example, I come from Haryana. Mm-hmm. If I look at Haryana's micro small enterprise facilitation council, it has been one of the most proactive. In fact, we have already issued orders, and I'm one of the members on that facilitation council, worth more than 100 crore, helping a number of entrepreneurs recover their payments. The second thing that I would say here is that the orders of the micro and small facilitation council do not have teeth of law.
Mm-hmm.
So ultimately, those orders need to go to revenue authorities for implementation.
Correct.
So I would say that maybe in due course of time, these micro small facilitation councils, their decisions are, you know, given some teeth for immediate and effective implementation, because I see many cases, particularly from Maharashtra, where even the orders of these facilitation councils are not effectively yielding results, because then these orders go to various courts of law and due course of recovery.
Basically, till it is decided, it's adjudicated, the money is stuck and the MSME is stuck.
That's right.
On the point that you're making on new company bills, the new company bill somehow has some deterrent impact on the facilitation that that this bill seeks to create, the MSME bill seeks to. What's that?
I think the new company bill, which is effective now starting 1st of April 2014. So while on one hand it does wish to contain or bring transparency to various listed companies and, you know, the large investor companies, somehow all the laws apply to micro and small enterprises as well. And there the issues are different. For example, raising funds from unsecured, loan through unsecured loans.
Hmm.
Often, as an entrepreneur would raise funds from mother, father, brothers, sisters, relatives, and friends.
Hmm.
Those may not be directors in the company.
Correct.
And so there is this bill, as on date, prohibits raising funds, unsecured loans, from unapproved sources, which means non-directors of the company,
mm-hmm.
and also those which are not institutions authorized by RBI. So now if a small entrepreneur wishes to raise some small unsecured fund from a brother, sister,
he can't do that.
Yeah. And the minimum penalty, you'll be surprised, is 1 crore.
So what actually is happening is they're trying to facilitate through MSME and trying to deter through company bill. Is that what you're trying to say?
I think company bill wanted to check instances of Satyam or other
large
companies.
But eventually it is applicable for MSMEs.
So I think for micro and small entrepreneurs, where fundraising itself is a major issue, particularly my equity raising and meeting with my daily contingencies, I don't have access to huge institutions for my credit funding.
Time for us to head into a break. When we come back, we will talk about the government plans to cut down government procedures and become more dynamic in matters of MSME. Welcome back. The bill proposes to amend the MSME Act to empower central government to vary, by way of notification, the investment limits. The central government may change these investment limits up to 3 times the specified limits through notifications.
The proposal to empower the central government to revise the investment limits time to time will benefit the MSMEs. Considering the inflation and dynamic market situation, there is a need to periodically revise the limits of investment. Revising the investment limits by way of notification will facilitate timely action, which would benefit these enterprises. As of now, the law lacks the dynamism and the government has to approach the parliament every time it wants to revise the investment limits.
This will give a wider area of operation and a large number of industries in certain areas where it was exclusively not coming because of lack of investment in plant and machinery. So the whole area of industrial activity will increase, and once the activities increase, that will generate more employment, and more specifically for the lower strata, for the middle class and for the workers. Therefore, it's a very bold step which should have been taken long back. Hopefully, the government has taken care of it.
There are quite a few benefits available to an enterprise that falls within the micro, small or medium enterprises. There are progressive policies and practices in respect of credit to the MSMEs so that there is a smooth and timely flow of credits. There is a procurement preference policy in respect of goods and services produced and provided by the MSMEs. There are one or more funds which will be credited to any grants made by the central government. The central government can also grant sums of money which it considers necessary to provide.
Increase in investment limits will lead to a situation where the small-sized companies who are presently designated as MSMEs can become larger and still have the benefits of MSMEs. This will lead to increased investments in technology, where actually the present MSMEs are falling behind the global competitors because they are not able to invest on the technologies, and technology is moving very fast, even in the information technology side or otherwise in the manufacturing side. So they will get that leverage of investments and still be considered an MSME and get all the benefits which accrue to the MSMEs.
The reservation policy in the MSMEs is considered beneficial for MSMEs. The reservation policy reserves certain items for exclusive manufacture by these enterprises, thus protecting their interests as well as providing impetus to the society by generating employment opportunities.
After the bill becomes a law, the major obstacle of less investment limits in the MSMEs will be resolved. But the negligence of banks still remains a big question. With cameraman Saroj, Dipali Pandit for Rajya Sabha Television.
The government feels decisions connected to business must be made dynamic, and that's why it has chosen to empower itself. The question to you, sir, is on the procurement part. You heard us giving a gist of 2006. What is the issue of implementation relating to procurement?
See, procurement policy, it has been mandatory since April that any large corporate or PSUs, they have to buy 20% from the MSEs units, in fact. But it was earlier also. But the implementation of that is not happening practically. Mm-hmm. Now, what the ministry has done, they have proposed a penalty of 2% also from the corporates or the PSUs who will not purchase at least 20% mm-hmm. from these MSC units. Mm-hmm. But the implementation is really how...
Who is responsible for implementation?
No, there are various issues. Like if I'll say some oil company, they don't have any item to purchase which will constitute to 20% of their total purchase. What they can purchase from the
So it can't
SME.
Be a blanket reservation
yes.
on all.
Yes.
And that is where the problem begins.
So suppose some oil company, so their major raw material or the major cost is oil.
Uh-huh.
How they can go reach up to 20%? It can be only some, you know, jhadu, this thing, so small items. But
it's a problem of codification
yes,
then.
Yes.
Coming to you, sir, revising the credit-linked capital subsidy, that is the point that you were making. We talked of facilitation of credit and all that, but beyond a point, this is what is the prescribed limit. You said 15% of 15 lakh or maximum 15 lakh. So if that's the credit...
Actually, this particular scheme is to encourage micro and small enterprises mm-hmm. to go in for higher technologies and invest more, mm-hmm. Look at the global standards and bring in the best, mm-hmm. particularly when we are focusing on zero defect and zero effect now. I think the last cap, which is 15 lakh, this was laid many years back, almost 8 years back. So the subsidy, while it is 15%, the cap is only 15 lakhs, mm-hmm. which means one can invest up to 1 crore and avail of this subsidy. While technology costs have gone higher, and also now Indian SMEs are looking at more opportunities to invest, particularly now with this new bill raising their definitions. So I have a, I
appeal to the government. So effectively what you're saying is that they have increased the definition cap, but have not actually increased where the money is going to come in from.
So I would suggest that this incentive, mm-hmm. The cap on this incentive should be raised from present 15 lakh mm-hmm. to 30 lakh at least, so that SMEs can invest in better technologies out of these limits which are prescribed to them.
Sir, on the exit policy and rehabilitation, very quickly, sir.
See, there are a lot of exit facilities available to large corporates, like BIFR is there, CDR mechanism is there. But this demand was, in fact, since long by the SME sector that there is no exit policy available to them. Now the government under Section 9 of the MSME Act has notified this rehabilitation and exit policy for the MSME sector. I suppose it will be a very good initiative of the government. Now the banks have to form some committees. Implementation has to be done. And corrective action plan has to be taken by the banks, in fact. So this is a good initiative. Let us see what happens ultimately.
On the startup and funding innovation.
Yeah, I think looking at the future, and particularly the interests of the youth. I mean, and I am very pleased to see that the limits of the service enterprises, I see in the definition, are being increased many times more than the manufacturing. Mm-hmm. I don't know the reason why, because in any case, the plant and machinery investment in a service enterprise is bare minimal. Mm-hmm. And so while their limits are being revised much more, the manufacturing limits are still lesser, on the lesser side. I wish they would do that. Looking at the startups, India needs to develop a strong investment policy, credit facilitation policy for startups, for innovations, funding. And there's a policy also which government has introduced. I think it is in the public domain. And
Skill India. Yeah,
that's right. No, other than Skill India, I'm talking about investment policy
startup schemes.
And
yes.
Government has, of course, introduced
venture funding.
Yeah, that's right. Huh. So I would say that is where we need to focus on, because India is very strongly emerging. Our youth, the technopreneurs who are coming out, and particularly looking at the new domains as yet untraveled. So how to fund those? The banks would need an entirely new mechanism. The government would need to set up a policy.
You're saying that needs to be included in the bill, or it should be there in the rules and guidelines so that we have a framework.
I'm saying that also should be part of the entire picture that is emerging. Mm-hmm. There are many steps being taken. These are various verticals, different acupressure points, if I would say.
Correct, that affect
an SME. Right. And I see good focus in the government that they are now moving ahead right from definition to exit policy, to investment innovation funding, to ease of doing businesses for SMEs in terms of simplification of labor laws. And Company Act Bill, I hope, would also be reviewed, but at least
to synergize it.
That's right.
Moving on, my colleague Dipali Pandit spoke to Mr. Sanjay Bhatia, President, Confederation of MSME, FICCI.
So how will the increase in investment limits benefit the industries?
You see, one of the thing is that these investment limits were fixed up in 2006. So with the inflation which has taken place in last 9 years now, I think they have virtually become outdated. And the increase in the investment limit, because especially I'm talking about the units who have already reached the peak, they're not able to move forward in terms of the new equipments, new technologies, to adopt them and to improve their productivity and production. I think this limit will, of course, help the existing units to move forward and adopt new technologies and make new investments.
So will the increase in investments affect employment generation?
You see, now with the revised limits, they would be able to absorb a new technology. They would be more competitive. They would be able to sustain their businesses and, of course, retain their existing employment and go for further expansions and all those things. Rather than, let's say, going horizontally, they would be moving vertically. They would be able to do that. So they would have benefit of scales and would be able to help the employment also.
So do you see any challenges which the industry could face after the increase in investment limits?
As regards the change in investment limit, as I said, from FICCI, Confederation of MSME, we welcome this. But we have also suggested to the government that rather than having a base of the investment base for defining an MSME, why not we have a turnover base? Because you see, if we have a turnover base, we feel in FICCI that it would be easier for anyone to identify that who is eligible to come under this sector, MSME.
Thank you, sir, for joining us on this discussion. It's time for us to end the show. You can email your suggestions and comments to law.rstv@gmail.com. You can also watch our shows on the RSTV page of YouTube. We'll be back with a new issue and a new episode. Keep watching Rajya Sabha TV.